Hi, everyone. My name is Rustem. I'm AWS Machine Learning Hero and Staff Machine Learning Engineer at Instrumental. And today I want to tell you how to harness low-code and no-code machine learning tools on AWS. So we entered a new era of AI. AI now is a commodity, so you don't need to build it from scratch to use. It's very low barrier to use or integrate AI or machine learning into your product, and you don't need to pay any upfront costs to use it. That affects multiple areas at once. For AI augmented workforce, it means that you can start using AI for solving day-to-day tasks or using AI as your personal assistant. In the area of AI as a core product, it means that you don't, if you want to build a product around AI, you don't need to have a dedicated machine learning team, and you can deploy something very early to get feedback from customers early. And finally, with AI as a support tool, it's very easy to embed AI features into your existing product and reduce costs of manual processes. So today I want to go through machine learning pipeline and challenges and show you different steps. Then I want to share the framework for comparing different low-code, no-code machine learning tools. After that, I will go into finer details about some low-code, no-code AWS machine learning services. And finally, I will show you the demo of SageMaker Canvas custom models. So first, let's start with machine learning pipeline. Here you can see the whole pipeline if you want to deploy machine learning into production. So you start with data acquisition and labeling, then you build the model itself. After that, you build the training pipeline where you train the model and prepare it for inference. After that, you deploy the model and organize infrastructure for it. And finally, you integrate your model into your production infrastructure. So you can see here is that there are multiple steps here. Complexity here is not just code. And actually, I think low effort, no effort machine learning better captures what's happening here. That it's not only optimizes the code you need to write, it also optimizes the data you need to label, the infrastructure you need to deploy. And the value here is that people with domain knowledge but without ML expertise can start getting value from ML. They can deploy machine learning models into production earlier to either get customer feedback or get value to the users. So if we take the pipeline, which I shared with you before, and put all steps on a line, so from gathering data set to integrating the model, we can put a spectre here. So here you can see this stack. And if particular step is marked as orange, it means it's handled by AWS. And if it's marked as purple, it means it will be handled by you. So on the left, we have integrated ML, meaning that everything is handled by AWS. With integrated AutoML means that you need to bring your data and you need to label it, but you don't need to worry about anything else. About machine learning as a service family, here you don't need to bring your data, but you still need to integrate the final endpoint into your product. And with managed pipeline, you effectively have to manage everything except for labeling. The thing here is that the integrated family effectively can be used by business analysts. So to the level that where you don't need to write even a single line of code, and you can start using machine learning on your data. The machine learning as a service or auto machine learning as a service can be integrated by backend engineer. You don't need a team of data scientists or machine learning engineers to do that. So in these cases, effectively, you can start getting value from machine learning very early with minimal resources. So if we put all these types of services on one axis, basically on the left side, we will have something like machine learning as a service, which is very easy to start, less customizable, but you don't have any training cost, and you pay per request, which is perfect if you have low volume or peak load. On the right side, you have managed pipeline with higher threshold to start. At the same time, it will be customizable for your task, and it may have lower cost at scale because you can adapt your model for your infrastructure and for your type of task. So now that we have this framework, we can put different AWS low-code, no-code tools and categorize them. So basically you can see this framework on the top, and you can see the types of tasks we need to solve, like visual tasks where we need to work with images or videos, text tasks where we need to, let's say, classify text snippets, or tabular tasks where we need to work with tables of data. And here you can see that, for example, you may have integrated ML where you have canvas plus recognition or text struct. You may have machine learning as a service, just recognition, or you may have just pre-trained model like Jumpstart. Don't worry that there are a lot of services here. I will go into details about each service later. But you can see that now it's clear, like for each type of service, like what part of the stack it will handle and what part will be handled by you. And on the top left corner, you can see canvas plus custom models plus different machine learning as a service family tools. So these were released on March 30th, meaning that it's very fresh, and you can start using machine learning on your image and text data right away without any code necessary. And I will show you how to do it during demo. So now let's look into each service which I mentioned before specifically. So first is machine learning as a service tools family. So effectively, it's a machine learning endpoint or service which you can call. You don't need to provision it separately, and you pay per request, which is awesome when you have low volume of requests. Model can be retrained, but it will need to be provisioned separately. Examples here are Amazon Recognition and TextTract and Amazon Comprehend. Next is SageMaker Autopilot. This is AutoML solution for tabular data, where you can train the model without writing code or choosing architecture. So what it will do, based on the data you provide, it will try multiple models and it will choose the best performing one. And you can easily integrate it with SageMaker Data Wrangler to have a custom data preprocessing. Also, no code necessary. So you can basically organize data preprocessing pipeline using UI tool. Next is SageMaker Canvas plus ready-to-use or custom models. This is no-code machine learning interface where you can either use ready models, ready-to-use models, or create ML models on your own automatically. So it's basically can be used for data exploration, training models, and it supports multiple data sources. Next is SageMaker Jumpstart. Effectively, this is a collection of pre-trained proprietary and publicly available models with easy way to deploy them. This collection is continuously updated. So for example, now it has foundational model like Stable Diffusion, and it has a simple one-click model deployment, meaning you can easily deploy this model into your account and you will get a Jupyter notebook to test the integration. And finally, SageMaker Ground Truth. That's a fully managed data labeling service. So it's very flexible. You can use it to label on your own or with your internal workforce, or you can use something like Amazon Mechanical Turk or third-party vendors for labeling. Another advantage with it is that it has ML-powered automation, meaning it can train model based on your labels and show predictions to the labelers, so they don't need to label from scratch. So how to decide on the tool which you need? So if you need fully complete solution, then integrated ML is your choice. And you can use it to start getting value from your data right away. If you have a very specific task, then it's better to use integrated AutoML, meaning you can train your own model and run predictions on your data. If you want to make ML part of your application, then you need to basically ask yourself, like, does machine learning as a service tool solve your problem? If yes, then you can just use it right away, just integrate it. If it doesn't perform well on your data, then you can use AutoML as a service. If that still doesn't work because it doesn't solve your type of task, then pre-trained model is your choice, and you would need to just deploy it without training. If it's too expensive at your scale, that means that you will probably need to organize the whole training pipeline so that you can optimize model for your infrastructure. The thing here is that it doesn't necessarily mean that you have to commit to a particular solution right away. It could be that in the beginning, you want to start with machine learning as a service to get some early customer feedback. Then you can switch to another one for AutoML as a service so that it performs better on your task while once you have more data. And finally, once you hit large scale, you can switch to managed pipeline because you want to optimize costs. So now let's switch to SageMaker Canvas custom model demo. So during this demo, we will get into SageMaker Canvas, see how the how working with images works, and how to train model and run predictions. So here right away, there are models you can use, and this is what I mentioned, like integrated ML. So models which you don't need to train. I prepared two datasets, Wildcats train and Wildcats test, which have two types of images, snow leopard and cheetah. So the good part here is that if you want to import data, you can do it either from local data source or from S3. So if we go to my models, basically here I already have a model I trained, but effectively what happens during build stage, you select model data which you want to use for training. So cheetah and snow leopard, you just need to label it. After it, it will use part of this data for training and part for validation, and it will show you model performance on this data. And not only you can see predictions which were made correctly or incorrectly, you can also see the scoring and how well the model performed. So you can see individual metrics for each label. And finally, you can run prediction drop. So either on individual image or make a batch prediction. So for example, I can select dataset, a Wildcats test, and I can generate predictions. It will take some time, but I already have previously run prediction on this dataset. So here we will see the predictions made by the model I trained. And you can see that not only it will classify each image, it will give me the confidence for each prediction. And what I can do, I can verify predictions, whether they have correct labels or not. and I can add them to the trained dataset. And once I added them to the training dataset, now I can build a new model, which would perform better because now it has more data. So to summarize today's presentation, low-code, no-code machine learning tools can help you in different cases, whether you're building your own product or you want to use machine learning for your day-to-day tasks. Thank you very much for your time, and would we be happy to respond to your comments in the comment section.